Now we know what the lower cost strategy is in Porter's theory, let's have a look how we can implement it. We're going to keep it real simple. And so there's four key ways that you can implement the lower cost strategy. One, economies of scale. Two, choice of product to offer. Three, human resource management. And four, operations management. We're going to apply these to Audi in another video later on. We're going to say Audi's very good at doing all of these things. Let's look at the first one. The first one is economies of scale. Very useful term, probably more of an economics term, not really in our course. So let's explain what it means, but it's very good for this topic. It means the business lowers the cost for each unit by producing or buying the product in such big quantities that it lowers costs. Why does it lower costs? Because the business and people, because they make so much of it, they get faster at producing it. Let's have a look at two employees in two different businesses. Employee A works at one business, and each week they make 30 units of whatever this is. One's, we'll call that beige, one's blue, one's green, and they're each different, okay? Now another employee also makes 30 units, but they make all this colored one, okay? Now, this person's making the same number overall, but three lots of 10. This person's making 30 lots of one, okay? And what happens there is that the longer you're doing that and just making the one thing, you're going to get faster at it. So let's say that when they first start in their first week at the job, this person can make 56 minutes. In 56 minutes, they can make one of these. And this person, also in 56 minutes. Well, after a year, who's going to be better at making the beige colored box here? Well, it's not going to be this person, because this person not only has to make the beige one, they're going to make the blue one and the green one, and they're all different. But this person, all they do is make the beige box. So after a year, this person might only take 48 minutes, which is an improvement. The productivity's improved, but this person's going to be flying. They've got it down to 29 minutes. And that's what businesses who use this lower cost strategy do. They buy or in such big quantities, and they only buy like one model. They buy a lot of one thing, not a lot of different things, not a little bit of many different things, just a lot of one thing. You get good at it. Also, how does it lower costs? Because suppliers charge lower prices. What does that mean? This supplier makes t-shirts. Okay, we've got two businesses over here, business A and business B. This business buys 1,000 t-shirts at a time. Okay, and they get a price of $20. But this business, business B, they buy 3,000 shirts. Now, this supplier, who do they prefer to sell to? The business that buys 1,000 t-shirts or the business that buys 3,000, they're going to prefer to sell to business B. And to do that, they're probably going to lower the price. The more you buy, the bigger the bulk discount you get. That's $14 per unit. This business is saving more than this business because it buys so much. So you can make a lot of something or you can buy a lot of something and you'll get what's called economies of scale. What else? The cost per unit of fixed cost goes down. What does that mean? We've got two businesses. They both pay $10,000 a month in rent to rent their factories. Business A rents this factory. Business B rents that factory. Well, rent's relative. It's like it doesn't change based on how many you produce. So this business makes 1,000 t-shirts. This business makes 5,000, okay? And what we say is that as a per unit cost, if there's $10,000 per month in rent, you're making 1,000 t-shirts, that's $10 rent for every t-shirt. That's a lot. You've now got to get that back at when you sell this t-shirt. So you're going to have to charge more. But this one, that's spreading $10,000 of rent over 5,000 t-shirts. That works out at $2 rent per unit. That's relatively a lower cost, and you're getting what's called economies of scale. Businesses who offer lower costs, they do that. They just maybe have a lot of rent, but they make so much of something, the relative cost per unit goes down. How else can you implement this strategy? Well, think about the choice of product you offer. Offer a product that has no frills, doesn't have a lot of fancy features. Fancy features equals expensive. We want a no frills product. Two, it's standardized and easy to make in large quantities. We did that when we did operations. Standardized, the product is identical with every unit. Three, it's easy to store. We don't want something that's going to be difficult and bulky and hard to carry or like has to be kept cool or chilled all the time. And lastly, something that we can buy in bulk quantities at a lower cost to get those economies of scale. So let's have a look at that. So we want something that's a no-frills product. We don't want to buy this fancy box over here and sell it. That's not for us. We'll let another business do that. We're just going to sell the basic product. We're going to make sure that it's the same. So we keep all, we're just going to sell black sneakers. Whereas this business might sell black sneakers, orange sneakers, blue sneakers. No, we're not going to do that. We're not going to do that. We're just going to keep it simple and keep everything standardized. Easy to store. We're gonna buy from a business that sells these sneakers in nice square boxes because then we can stack them nice and easy and they take up less space. This business also sells black sneakers, But let's say the boxes were like triangle, or they're trying to be cool and have a distinct brand with their packaging. Yeah, that's cool, but look how much extra space that takes up. That's not for us, okay? We don't want something that's going to be difficult to store. And lastly, we want to buy from suppliers who are going to sell us a heap and not a little. What else can we do to become lower cost? We can use some HR strategies from earlier in the year. We can recruit employees with lower wages, either younger employees, overseas labor, for example. Lower wages means lower costs. We can train and develop our employees to be more efficient. That'll bring the prices down. We can reward existing employees using financial and non-financial rewards to increase their motivation to become more efficient. And we can terminate inefficient employees and replace them with more efficient workers. And lastly, we can implement this strategy with operation strategies to make our business ch more efficient or cheaper. Going back to the beginning, about the middle of the year, we said there's all these strategies that you can use for operations. We don't need to talk about all of them now. I'm just going to pick some. I'm just going to pick those four. I think if you spoke about these four as ways to bring prices down, you'd be doing really good because automation, just-in-time management, inventory, total quality management, and lean management, they're all going to lower costs. Automation is going to get rid of humans with robots. Robots work longer, they work faster. Two, just-in-time will reduce the amount of warehouse space you need, so you're going to save money on storage and people. Three, total quality management will continuously improve operations efficiency and fix errors before they occur. That's cost savings. And lastly, lean management is where you get rid of all the waste. So less waste means less time, less space, and employees needed. Together, all these things are going to bring down your costs and therefore your prices.